YouTube, my name is Mesa Sean, and welcome back to another Destiny 2 video. Alright folks, we have a ton of Destiny 2 Shadowkeep DLC news to go over in this video. Also, at the end of the video, I'll be doing a Scuf Controller giveaway. As you probably already know, I am sponsored by Scuf Controllers, and I have my own Mesa Sean Scuf Controller. So stick around to the end of the video if you're interested in winning one. So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to round up everything that we learned yesterday, including some new things that you did not get to see just yet. There's a new press kit that's out there with a ton of new screenshots. We get to see some new mods, we get to see a new Titan exotic, and a few other things. So we're going to go through those, but let's recap a few things from yesterday's trailers. Now, if you enjoy this video, a like rating is very much appreciated, and subscribe if you're not a subscriber. Let's get into it. First off, let's talk about the Destiny 2 Shadowkeep Season of the Undying trailer, which is all about the Vex. We will be having Vex invasions that will be occurring all over the solar system. In fact, when we go back and take a look at the map for the moon, it looks like the Vex are invading the moon. And in some of the high-res screenshots that I'm going to show you later on in the video, yeah, the Vex are there, and it looks like we're kind of getting a re-skin version of the Vex, these Black Garden type of Vex, because they have all that Black Garden stuff all over them. One thing that was pretty interesting yesterday was my comment section lighting up with, well, this is recycled content. Actually, no, guys. Yeah, this was made a long time ago, or at least the first, like, 30 or so seconds, but it never made it into any trailer or into any of the DLCs from whether it was Destiny 1 or Destiny 2. We did know that there was supposed to be a DLC called Vex Void, and I have a feeling that we're looking at it, that Vex Void is going to be what these Vex invasions are for Season of the Undying. So technically, it is new because it never was officially released. It was leaked and it made it to, I believe, Vimeo, I think, had it. I don't know. Someone tweeted me earlier that, hey, this was just recently on Vimeo and then it got deleted. So either way, it's cool, guys. I think it's an awesome trailer. What do you think of the trailer? We saw some new finishing moves or finishers. Now, let's talk about this real quick because a number of folks were complaining that, well, is this an Eververse thing and that you have to pay for these finishers? Well, you have to pay for the ones that look cool probably, or they'll be in some sort of engram or whatever. But the actual finishing move, the benefits to them, like there's one called Heavy Finisher. Finishers grant heavy ammo, requires one half of your super energy, and that will drop that heavy brick for everyone on your fire team. Now, this finisher you will get from in-game, either from your artifact or from a mod socket that you will put on your character. However, the actual animation of whatever it is, like the wheel kick, okay, I am throwing money at the screen for that one because I train in Muay Thai and kickboxing. So, yeah, I'll be buying that. But, yeah, the actual cosmetic aspect of the finisher, I believe that's going to be through Eververse, but the actual what the finisher does, that's earned in-game, folks, so everyone calm down. We did get a good look at the artifact for this season called the Gate Lord's Eye. Now, you will unlock mod sockets that you could put into armor, and also there will be a weapon mod sockets that will come from the artifact that you could put on weapons. And actually, on your weapons, when you're looking down in the lower left-hand side of your screen, you could see a little icon right next to the element that shows off what kind of mod you're using on that weapon. And we're going to see some new mods coming from these screenshots, which I'll show towards the end of the video. But what I'm gathering from the artifact mods is they take up a lot of energy. Now, each piece of armor will have 10 energy, or at least when you level it up, it will have 10 energy. Now, some of these towards the end will take up 7 energy if you want to slot them in, which only gives you 3 energy left to put in something else. But some of the ones that you unlock early on will require 1 energy, some 1, or it looks like 0, but this could be a dev build. But also, we see some Vex ones down at the bottom left-hand side of the screen. So this is going to be a seasonal artifact, and all of this looks like it's going to reset at the end of the season, and all these will go the way of the dodo, and we'll have a new artifact for the following season. So let's go over the mods that they did show from the artifact. So we already went over the Heavy Finisher, that's going to take up 7 energy. But we have Thundercoil, grants bonus damage to all Arc melee abilities, and refunds super energy on finisher final blows. Then we have Arc Battery, grants an overshield, and reduces cooldown during activation for all Arc class abilities. Then we have Oppressive Darkness, causing damage with a Void Grenade adds a weaken effect to enemies. Then we have anti-barrier rounds, and here's where we get into the mods for the weapons. So shield-piercing rounds designed to bypass combatant defenses, strong against barrier champions, and this one right here is for auto rifles and SMG only. Then we have the anti-barrier hand cannon, so that's going to be the same thing except for hand cannons. Then we have overload rounds. Uninterrupted fire grants bullets that cause disruption, delaying ability energy regeneration, and lowering combatant damage output. Strong against overlord champions, auto rifles, and SMGs only. And when you're playing the game, you'll be able to look down in your lower half side of the screen where you have your HUD and see which mods or artifact mods you have on your weapons. Now, it looks like we're getting some sort of Void Galahorn, as I'm calling it, or like a Nova Bomb type of rocket launcher, as we see this fight here where the Guardians are fighting a nightmare of what looks to be Omnigull, because we hear that good old Omnigull scream. But it looks like the rocket does track, and it looks like it splits off into these little Void Nova Bombs. So, well, that's what Galahorn did. It tracked, and it split off into Wolfpack rounds. So, yeah, I'm calling this thing the Void Galahorn for Destiny 2 Shadowkeep. It's Danny1 over on Reddit put this image together, and it's a full version, or it looks to be like a full version, of the map of the moon. Now, we see a number of things. One is we see the three nightmare icons. We'll get into that in a little bit. We see one strike. We see two landing zones. We see a bunch of lost sectors, a bunch of treasure chests. We see our familiar places from Destiny 1, the Hellmouth, Archer's Line, Anchor of Light. We see the fallen ship. We also see Vex symbols all over the place. You can see them in the top. Well, some of them are grayed out, but you can see them at the top, the bottom. And what I think that means is that how the Vex invasion is supposed to take place and vary from destination to destination. So probably this week or this part of the season, the moon is being overrun by the Vex. We do see one strike on the moon, and that's called the Scarlet Keep. And it says, investigate the recently erected Scarlet Keep and discover its dark purpose. Now, we have a new activity called Nightmare Hunts, and it says Nightmare Hunt Servitude. That's only one of three that we see on the map. Now, it looks like this is going to be a new activity, and it says here, weekly complete any Nightmare Hunt activities. All difficulty tiers grant progress. So, I wonder if this is only going to be for the moon, or will these occur on other destinations? I have a feeling they're going to occur on other destinations. Let me know what you think in the comments section. Now, we do have some new difficulties, and we see Adept, Hero, and we see Legend. Now, Adept is going to be 860, Hero is going to be 920, and Legend is 950, and those that leave me a hashtag made it to the end, you guys become Legend. I know, bad joke. The one nightmare that they do describe is called Servitude. Defeat the nightmare of Zydron, the Gatelord, and that was the Gatelord from the story mission in Destiny 1. Now, the modifiers we see here, we see Air Superiority, Champions Overload, Champions Barrier, Match Game, and Torment of Zydron. Now, what do they mean by champions? We keep seeing that word champions. Are they renaming yellow bars or named enemies? Sound off in the comments section. What do you think? Now, let's go through a bunch of screenshots from the Bungie press kit. Now, this one is from the Black Garden. The raid is going to take place in the Black Garden, and on the right-hand side of the screen, we see a number of guardians. Left-hand side of the screen, we see in the walls, kind of reminds me of the Vault of Glass, and yeah, it looks pretty cool. Next up, we have a warlock over at Archer's Line over on the moon, and he is holding this new exotic trace rifle, which was shown off in the original Viaduct for Shadowkeep. And he's fighting the Vex, and it looks like this would be part of the Vex invasion. Now, these Vex don't look like normal Vex, they look like Black Garden Vex. They have the little tree branches all over them, so clearly it looks like these invader Vex are coming from the Black Garden. Hopefully there'll be some sort of backstory or lore behind why they're invading, and what we actually get for stopping the invasion. Okay, next up, we're over at the Keep, and we see some Crota swords on the floor, or Hive swords that looks like we're going to pick up. We see, it looks like another Taken portal, or a portal into some other dimension, and it looks like they're fighting a Shrieker, and as I mentioned before, the Hive now have kind of like a reddish look to them. They've got more spines on them, and it looks like that Shrieker has it too, so we're kind of getting some reskinned Vex in this DLC, and also some kind of reskinned Hive, where the Hive had this red stuff all over them, and I pointed out in a previous video that a number of areas within the moon have this kind of red gook or red stuff all over the floor and walls, similar to how when the Taken first arrive or wherever the Taken are, they splash that Taken stuff all over the walls and floor. Now, here's the number of images of this new, it looks like an exotic heavy bow. Now, they teased this a little bit in the original Vidoc, and also in one of the images we see the hunter holding the new exotic hand cannon, which has a little bit of a like a big ACOG sight on it. But the Void Bow, I don't know anything about it, but it's big, and supposedly it's a heavy bow. So I'm expecting that thing to really pack a punch, and I really hope it has some really interesting perks. But looking at these screenshots, this bow looks absolutely epic. We'll just have to see what the main perks are on it. Next up, we have an exotic set of boots for the Titan called Phoenix Cradle. This one's going to be for your Sunbreaker, and the main perk is called Beacons of Empowerment. Now, this is cut off here, but we can kind of read into it. What we can read is your Sun Warrior benefit will last twice as long, and I think that means when you stand in your sunspot. Then it says allies who pass through your sunspot, I think, will also benefit from Sun Warrior. Next up, we get a look at a raid mod, and this one's called Enhanced Voltaic Ammo Collector. I hope I'm saying that right. Probably not. Active only in the Garden of Salvation raid. And it says greatly increases the chances of finding heavy ammo while you have the Voltaic Overflow buff. Multiple copies of this mod stack to increase the benefit. So it looks like that's going to be one of the raid mechanics right there. The Voltaic Overflow buff. We'll have to find out when the raid drops. Next up, we see this hunter here holding another exotic hand cannon. Now, that's the exotic hand cannon we saw in the original Vidoc. Now, we don't know a whole lot about it, but it was still in production and it had no name or anything, but clearly it's something they want us to see because they keep showing it in all the action pieces and also in screenshots like this. But looks pretty cool, but will it perform cool? We'll have to find out. Now, before we saw the Dreamable Hood, which was the Luna helmet for the Warlock, now we have the Dreamable Cowl, which is the helmet for the Hunter. Now, we see an intellect mod, and that's going to cost you 5 energy. But look on the right-hand side. Just for 5 energy, well, I guess 5 energy is a lot, but you get a pretty good boost to your intellect. And if you don't already know, intellect is all about getting your super back. The discipline stat is all about getting your grenade energy back, and your strength is all about your melee. The rest of the screenshots I'll let play in the background while we do the giveaway, because there's really not much to talk about. Some finishing moves, some nice landscape photos of the keep, and also good old Eris Morn. So here's how we're going to do the giveaway. The giveaway is for a scuff controller of your choice. Preferable if you would like a Mesa Shawn scuff impact or a Mesa Shawn scuff vantage. However, if you do want one of the other scuff controllers or a non-Mesa Shawn scuff, I totally understand that. I use scuff controllers for everything within Destiny 2, vantage or the impact. And I have a PC build coming this weekend. No, I'm not going PC full-time. I'm going to still main a PS4 Pro, but I ordered a ridiculous PC, which will be here this weekend. But I've been using a gaming laptop to just, well, get ready for PC and get ready for CrossSave to make content on CrossSave, and I plugged my scuff controller right in, and it works like a glove. I just had to up the sensitivity a little bit compared to what I have it on with regards to my PS4 Pro, but the scuffs work amazing on PC if you're into controller and want to ease into mouse and keyboard. To enter the giveaway, you got to leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and follow me on Twitter. My Twitter handle is @MesaShawn. Then from there, leave me a comment about something you noticed in these two trailers that is making you very excited about Shadowkeep. And also be sure in that comment, you put your Twitter handle in there. And then when I randomly pick a winner, I'll DM you on Twitter, and I'll get all your information and have Scuff send you a controller of your choice. Preferably, grab a Mesa Shawn Scuff Impact or Vantage, but if not, I'll send you whatever Scuff controller you want. That's it, guys. Leave me a good old hashtag made it to the end if you did make it to the end, and do me a favor. Drop a like in this video only if you see fit. Follow me on Twitter @MesaShawn. Check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube, and that's it. I am out of here like Vladimir.